네, 안녕하십니까. 헤드라인 뉴스 또 다섯 개의 흥미로운 기사를 가지고 찾아뵙게 되었습니다. 이번 주가 아마 지난주보다 조금 더 상대적으로 좀 쉽고 듣고 내용을 따라하기에 좀 편했던 것 같고요. 그리고 내용도 좀 이렇게 그냥 쉽게 다가갈 수 있는 게 많았던 것 같습니다. 예, 첫 번째 내용은 GM 이제 카어쉐어링. 예, 그거를 어떤 특정 지역에 산다고 하는데요. 예, 무슨 내용인지 같이 한번 들어보도록 하겠습니다.
The Maven unit of General Motors is testing a peer-to-peer car sharing service. The company says it works just like Airbnb. It allows owners or lessees to rent out their vehicles when they're not using them. That includes Chevrolets, Buicks, GMCs, and Cadillacs of the 2015 model year or newer. The owner keeps 60% of the rental price, GM takes the balance. For now, the service is only available in Detroit, Ann Arbor, and Chicago, but GM says it'll expand to other U.S. markets in the fall. Edmunds Manager of Industry Analysis, Jeremy Acevedo.
We'll see. This is definitely our first taste of this. This is what GM is doing. They're trying a lot of little things to kind of see what sticks for the future. Viability right now, we don't think that it's got a whole lot of legs, but if this is one of the technologies or services that takes off, GM will be right at the forefront.
With the new peer-to-peer car sharing service, General Motors and Maven are following in the footsteps of popular startups such as Turo and Getaround. And just like them, they're stepping on the toes of car rental giants such as Hertz and
네, 두 번째 기사 또 바로 시작하겠습니다. 예, 두 번째 기사는 도널드 트럼프의 새로운 멸종 위기종에 있는 보호법 개정과 관련된 내용이 되겠습니다. 조금 어려울 수도 있을지도 있겠네요. 예, 어쨌든 들어보겠습니다.
Enterprise.
Bald eagles, gray whales, and grizzly bears. Three species brought back from the brink of extinction thanks to the U.S. Endangered Species Act, which the Trump administration has proposed changing. The revisions would end a practice that automatically gives the same protections for threatened species as endangered species. End would evaluate a species' critical habitat initially only in places where it currently lives, not where it could live if its population recovered. The Interior Department's proposal would also end the language that prohibits considering economic impacts when deciding how animals should be protected. Republicans have long argued the 1973 Endangered Species Act restricts economic development by limiting, for example, drilling and mining. But conservation groups are blasting the proposed changes as an assault on wildlife protections.
네, 어쨌든 정치적인 내용은 결코 쉬운 게 하나도 없는 것 같습니다. 세 번째 기사는 일본에서 카지노 리조트 그 관련 허용 관계된 그 법규 내용인데요. 글쎄요, 가만 생각해 보니까 참 몰랐네요. 그 다른 나라마다 그 법이 다르지 않습니까? 그래서 또 나라 안에서도 어떤 주, 뭐 한국으로 얘기하면은 뭐 도가 되겠죠. 예, 그래서 어디선 되고 어디선 안 되고 자국민은 되고 자국민은 안 되고 뭐 그런 게 적용이 다르니까는 예, 무슨 내용인지 같이 한번 보도록 하겠습니다.
Japan's placing a bet on its future with casino resorts. On Friday, the country passed a law that would smooth the way for large-scale gambling, a business that's expected to generate billions of dollars in revenue. Casinos have been legalized since 2016, but lawmakers hadn't approved how they should run until now. Even as Prime Minister Shinzo Abe personally pushes for a casino industry, Japanese companies have been reluctant. Nobody wants to be the first mover in a controversial industry. The new law on Friday will likely give things a kickstart. It provides details of how the industry will be regulated and an initial three licenses. According to industry insiders, it sets the stage for a high-stakes race.
Analysts say that this sector is going to generate up to $25 billion in revenue for casino operators, and the government really hopes that that is going to give a boost to regional areas as well. That's parts of Japan where you have this huge population decline.
In terms of potential locations, Osaka, west of Tokyo, is seen as a frontrunner. There's been strong local political support for casinos, and the city's expected to become the first to request proposal plans by late 2019.
네, 그 다음 소식 세 번째 거 보도록 하겠습니다. 예, 세 번째 거는 Engineers turn trash into car parts in Venezuela. 그래서 자동차 어떤 부품을 가지고 그거를 죄송합니다. Turn trash, turn A into B죠. 예, 그래서 쓰레기를 말 그대로 쓰레기를 자동차 부품으로 바꾼대요. 그래서 그게 어떻게 가능한지 지난번 그 뉴스 아티클 중에서도 하나가 있었죠. 예, 집안에 있는 나오는 모든 생산되는 집안에서 만드는 쓰레기를 가지고 집 그 hot water 뜨거운 물을 끓이는데 만드는데 예, 사용하는 예, 엄청난 기술을 보였던 기억이 나는데요. 예, 어쨌든 뭐 비슷한 맥락이 아닐까 싶습니다. 예, 네 번째 기사 예, 들어보도록 하겠습니다.
Albemarle Dominguez and John Nazer see treasure in trash. The engineers are combing through a garbage dump full of broken electronic hardware at their alma mater in Caracas. They see opportunity and a chance to help the collapsing economy of Venezuela. They melt the plastic down and feed it through 3D printers. That recycling produces intricate pieces such as car parts. Those components are hard to get in a country where currency controls curb import of basic materials. The engineers aim to make them cheaper for manufacturers that depend on expensive imports. Dominguez, co-founder of the company Nedraki, with Nazir.
First, we are producing the prime material on a national level. Second, we are doing this while focusing on a circular economy, using residue from other industrial processes, recycling them so that we are able to produce goods. Third, we are making sure this technology reaches more people.
Porque queremos que la impresión 3D crezca en el país.
Nedraki has struck a deal with a recycling plant to get more material. It produces only a kilogram of plastic filament a day. But it now supplies 13 firms and produces plastic parts like transmission gear cogs. The engineers are now trying to encourage other Venezuelan companies to adopt 3D printing technology.
네, 대단하네요. 어쨌든 간에 참 3D 그 프린팅 기술이 저는 뭐 그렇게 대단한 거라고까지 생각은 안 했는데 예, 이게 점차 활용되면서 그전에는 생각하기 어려웠던 그런 어떤 새로운 시장들이 제가 봤을 땐 발견되는 것 같습니다. 예, 뭐 정말 대단하네요. 예, 벌써 마지막 기사입니다. 예, 마지막 기사는 Rural Renewal, an Uphill Battle in China. 예, 농촌 재개발을 위한 중국의 힘겨운 싸움 뭐 제목이 그렇게 되어 있네요. 그래서 아마 시진핑이 젊은 인재들 예, 잘 나가는 사람들을 도시에서 다시 농촌으로 뭐 이렇게 보내고 뭐 하는 그런 내용이었던 걸로 알고 있습니다. 예, 어떤 내용인지 다 같이 들어보도록 하겠습니다. 마지막 기사입니다.
There's a brain drain in China's countryside. Farms like these are dying as young people head to booming cities for work, and the elderly are left behind. So President Xi Jinping is trying something that was once unthinkable, move talent back to rural areas. It may seem counterintuitive for a nation that sees urbanization as a ticket to prosperity, but the government's worried about social unrest and the growing gap between the rich and the poor. For young Chinese like Li Jinglong, who's seen a pretty good life in the city, moving back to the countryside is a hard sell.
My goal is to stay in Changsha, where my work can be seen and acknowledged by more people. As far as I'm concerned, I can't realize this in rural villages.
Xi announced the program late last year, and he calls it rural rejuvenation. It's an idea that may be easier said than done. China's rural economies are mostly made up of small farms and outdated factories. Some provinces are offering millions to fix creaking infrastructure and launch countryside startups. But the few that have taken on the great rural move so far don't seem too happy.
What we saw on the ground was aging farmers and youngsters who have returned to the countryside and small cities only wanting to go out again sooner than later.
There are signs of hope. Some regions do have natural resources, like tea production. But for now, China's cities are still seen as the place where one can prosper.
네, 다섯 개 기사 다 들으셨습니다. 뭐 늘 말씀드리지만은 다시 한번 이렇게 비디오를 보시면서 밑에 물론 자막이 나가지만요. 최대한 들어보시고 안 들렸을 때는 바로 뒤로 가셔가지고 자막 확인하시고 모르는 단어 표현은 제가 그 뭐 당연히 아시겠지만은 예 관련 링크를 아래 적어 놓겠습니다. 거기 오시면은 어휘 표현 정의가 돼 있고요. 또 그것들을 활용한 예문들도 있으니까는 훨씬 이해하는데 도움이 될 겁니다. 다음 주에는 또 다른 기사, 다른 소식으로 찾아뵙도록 하겠습니다. 수고하셨습니다.